Hello and welcome to the feature detail. Today it's all about profiles. The feature detail is a supplement to the manual that comes as a PDF to every user of SolidSteel Parametric for Autodesk Inventor. Everything is explained in more detail in the manual, but we recommend that you just follow the video and do what you see step by step in the software yourself. For those who don't know, you can also try everything with the free express version. Visit our website now and get your license. Okay. In general, SolidSteel Parametric can place profiles on normal 2D or 3D Inventor sketch lines. These lines must be part of a sketch and a part within the assembly. The beams dialog is divided into logical sections that allow us to place profiles in a variety of ways. That's where we'll start now, let's go! We open the beam dialog by clicking on Create Beam in the upper left corner. A small sketch with four lines is already prepared here, which we can use to try out all the functions in the beam section. First of all, the beam dialog expects us to define where we want to place the beam. We do this by simply clicking on a line and immediately getting a preview. We can also select several lines at the same time and thus add several profiles in a single operation. In the next section, Choose Beam, we can define the profile precisely. The order of the drop-down menus is from large to small, starting with the international standard at the top. Next, the basic geometric shape, such as I, T, L, etc., or a round tube for example, can be defined in the type section. Then comes the selection of the profile series, probably the most frequently used selection filter, and finally, here at the bottom, the exact size can be selected within the selected series. By the way, SolidSteel Parametric comes with an international profile library. I'll leave the other settings as they are, we'll look at them later. We can either confirm our entries with Execute, which will close the dialog, or we can click on the plus and the dialog will stay open. We have now placed the first beams, and we can see here in the structure tree that two parts have been created. The dialog is still open. We can now continue without making any settings in the dialog. A click on the horizontal line and we get a preview of another profile. The profile is the right size as SolidSteel always remembers the last entries. But of course the beam is not well positioned, which brings us to step 2 of the tutorial. We want to define a vertical offset, and we do this here in the parallel offset section of the dialog. If we change the height offset here to top, we can see that the beam is moved down by half its height. Top means that the sketch line is at the top of the profile. Of course, we can also combine these parallel offsets like this. This makes no sense in this example, but the combination of the two parallel offsets results in a total of 9 possible orientations of the system line within the profile cross-section. This means that all common installation situations are covered and defined very quickly. This brings us to step 3, the rotation and flip direction. We could also rotate the profile, say 45 degrees, but that makes little sense in this situation. I go back to 0 degrees, confirm, and the profile is placed. We now have another diagonal sketch line on which to place an L profile that could be a bracing for example. We do this using the steps we just learned. First, we define the profile by selecting L at type. The other specifications at series and size fit well here, so I can leave them as they are. Click on the line and the preview appears. We can see more up close. The opening of the L profile is currently facing up, which is normally not the way to install them as it is easier for water to stay in the profile. Diagonal like this, the danger of standing water is more theoretical, but I still want to show the functionality. You know SolidSteel always remembers the last settings. So the height offset is still set to top and I set it back to center. Okay, back to the orientation of the L section. You might think that the flip checkbox would flip the opening of the L down, but it does not. The flipped option reverses the start and end points of the profile. As you can clearly see here, the vertical of the L profile has now been moved to the right side as seen from here. With symmetrical profiles, such as I profiles, you wouldn't be able to see the difference. But with shapes like RL, it may be necessary so that every possible orientation can be achieved. We don't need it here, so I turn it off. Instead, I rotate the profile 270 degrees and we can see in the preview that the open side of the profile is now facing down. Now we move the whole thing to the center of the column with the height offset to bottom. Why is the height offset moving the profile horizontally here? This is due to the 270 degrees rotation. The offsets always refer to the standard orientation of the profile. Our bracing now sits well on the column and we could connect it with a centered gusset plate. Okay, zoom out a bit, and we see a problem that brings us to step 4, the free offsets. Up here, the profile we just added ends right at the intersection of the sketch lines, so it hits the bottom of the beam instead of the column. To correct this, we could either modify the sketch or open the free offsets section of the dialog and make the adjustments there. We can immediately see the coordinate system at the start and end points, and can move the point here right away. I'll just enter 300 millimeters for the x-axis at the start point, and we can see what happens in the preview. It would work here in this case, and most importantly, we don't have to change the sketch. This is one of the great advantages of free offsets because the sketches often come from structural analysis software. In structural analysis, the member structures are always idealized, so that a bracing ends exactly at the node. In steel design, however, it is more likely that the connection is only close and there is a small distance to the calculated point. This does not really change the static system. Okay, back to moving the start point. We move the point 300 millimeters, which is correct, but of course not 300 millimeters down, but in the direction of the red arrow, which is the x-axis of the component. We reset the value to 0 back to the initial situation. We can modify the coordinate system up here. I select the Y orientation with a line selection. I click on the vertical line and specify that the Y orientation follows exactly this line. We can immediately see that the coordinates have been adjusted, and now we can move our point in the direction of the axis by specifying Y with, for example, 300 millimeters. The distance from the start point of the coordinate system to the end point of the profile is now exactly defined. We can now do the same here at the end point and offset this point by, for example, 300 millimeters. That's not correct, by minus 300 millimeters, of course. And we can see now that we can move the profile independently of the system line. Okay, we confirm this and the profile is placed. That was a lot of input in a short time, just take your time to practice. Now, in step 5, let's take a quick look at how free offsets behave with parametric changes. To do this, we will edit the sketch. For example, set the height to 2600 mm, and change the width to 3000 mm. Exit the sketch and then update in SolidSteel. Now we can see that the changes have been preserved. To be specific, the design has been enlarged, but the defined offsets have remained at 300 millimeters each and have not been scaled proportionally. This is an advantage in most cases, but as it is a bit semi-parametric, here is a note that free offsets have fixed values and are not scaled. This brings us to step 6, modifying profiles. We start the beam dialog again. Up here we have these three tabs, of which we have only used the first one so far. We can delete the profiles with delete, we'll do that in a moment, but for now let's take a closer look at the change tab. Here we can see that the last used settings are displayed. If we now select a beam, we can see that all settings for the selected profile are loaded. Now we can make changes here, for example we could move this profile to the outside, then confirm and the adjustment is done. As mentioned before, we will now delete a profile. We use the beam dialog in the delete tab, we select a profile, confirm and the profile is instantly deleted. In this example, the profiles were simply placed without any further editing. However, if there are cuts or connections on a profile, they would also be automatically removed when the beam is deleted. Okay, with a little practice you should be comfortable working with profiles now, so let's move on to some technical details in step 7. To do this, we will open a beam and take a closer look at it. We can see that the beam is a normal Inventor file with a normal extrusion. We extrude from the center to both sides, which has several advantages, such as not cutting away the sketch when we cut the part. We could now make normal edits to the part, such as material changes and other adjustments. SolidSteel parts also have some special hidden attributes that control our parametric. For example, we are often asked if the names of the parts can be changed. Of course this is no problem, it does not interfere with the parametric. You are welcome to name the parts whatever you like. It makes it easier to find them in the feature tree, especially for large assemblies. If we change and update the parameters after renaming, everything works as usual, and the newly assigned names are still the same. So much for profiles, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. You can also find more information on our website.